to freeze over. You can see there are a couple cars on the road, but we haven't seen too many people out and about. We're hoping that they took Mark's advice to get home or avoid the roads completely, you know, before it starts getting dicey out here. When we were downtown, we did see a lot of wind and, you know, people bundled up. We saw signs getting pushed over. And when we were driving downtown from 26, we did see a lot of people weren't really hitting the highway either, so that's a good sign.
Is that your tablet doing that?
Wind pushing us around there. And again, you can see here, not a lot of people on the road. We're driving pretty smoothly, so of course, we'll keep you posted on how things are starting to look as it gets colder and things get icier. For now, we're live in West Portland, Newering, Foxville, Oregon.
All right, Drew, thank you so much for keeping us posted. Well, and because of the icy road conditions that are possible, many places are closing. In Clackamas County, all county offices and clinics are closed now through tomorrow. Road crews have been de-icing the roads. We're told they're working around the clock to de-ice and plow roads when necessary. Several warming shelters are open right now. County staff is also reaching out to the most community to provide vouchers for hotels, other assistance with power. Homeless advocates gathered for a vigil to remember those who have died while living on the streets. Clackamas County's longest night vigil was held at Liberty Plaza in Oregon City last night. It was in honor of 348 unhoused Oregonians who died between January and September of this year. This event focused on the 13 people who died in Clackamas County during that time. Organizers say it's important to remember how dangerous this time of year can be for people who don't have a
the longest night, it's the darkest day of the year, so we need to be coming together to remember those losses. But it's also, you know, it's the beginning of
is that a game that's making that most bill?
Let's take another look outside. This is our Portland Shriners camera. You can see, boy, it just looks cold out there. It definitely feels like it if you step outside. Let's check in with Foxwell's Camille Ortino.
Yeah, very, very cold out there, Nora. That east wind is roaring, just driving the feels like temperatures down into the single digits, and even depending on where you are. So we're still seeing dry conditions here from our Rivermark Community Credit Union camera. You can see Tolkien Crossing. Surface still clear, but we know that precipitation is close by. It'll be here in the next couple of hours. Temperatures still in the low 20s. We haven't really moved much today. And look at this morning's low temperatures. Just frigid. This is bitter.
It's not like it's coming from over here.
The low at PDX, exposed hills, and then parts of the eastern metro.
So your game's making a bell sound, right? Okay.
Gresham, Corbett started the day 12 degrees this morning. So pulling up our radar once again just to check to see where things are. Kind of a variety of precipitation that's coming through here. Radar kind of guessing at what's coming down, but it could be a combination of snow, ice pellets, freezing rain, regular rain. Point is, this is pushing into the metro area. Some parts of that I-5 corridor already starting to see some stuff coming down. This looks really light for this kind of initial round, but if you're around Salem, McMinnville, western portions of the Portland metro, like Hillsboro, maybe starting to see some precipitation. So once again, your storm timeline here for that I-5 corridor, that wintry mix is spreading into the valley right now. Roads will turn icy later tonight, and we're going to stay frozen. We're not warming up, so that's really the biggest take-home message here, is once things ice over tonight, they will remain iced over all day tomorrow. Nora?
All right, Camilla, thank you. It's not just people we're worried about during the cold weather. Several dogs were recently found abandoned out in the cold in Washington. Those dogs are now recovering, but as Fox 12 News Silverman reported, this is exactly what local animal shelters are hoping to avoid.
Abandoning your pet is not only wrong, but it's illegal. It could result in criminal charges, and shelters want you to know they can help. Doug Lewis says it's important to keep in mind just because your pet has a fur coat does not mean that they're warm. In fact, hypothermia is very possible for animals, so you should really keep them warm and bundled up. But when you do take them outside during this weather, try to avoid snow melt and chemicals that are used out on the roads or the sidewalks. They say it's also a good idea to wipe off the animal before coming back inside, so there's no chance of them licking off any potential toxins. And you should also make sure that they're drinking plenty of water during this weather. Dehydration can be life-threatening and lead to problems in the cold. Now, back to those animals we showed you recently found in Skagit County, north of Seattle. We know at least
Skagit County
abandoned there over the past few
never
days.
Heard of Skagit County.
Temperatures, including this dog called Lulu, a little brown dog there who is diabetic. It is now getting some help. We know none of these dogs were tagged or microchipped.
There you go.
Huh? There's always one way or another to get a hold of us.
No, that's yours.
Please call 911.
Is this your pop at the door? It must be, huh?
Yeah.
A little one, okay.
What you do is cold. And it goes through your bones. My goodness. Why do the animals have to suffer? And it's great time to bust out those holiday bags for your dogs, the booties, and if you're walking them at night, a reflective leash, collar, and coat is a great idea. Shelters understand many families are facing tough times right now, so if you do need help, they really urge you to contact animal control or your local shelter. They can help connect you with the resources you need. For now, reporting in studio, Bonnie Saltman, Fox 12, Oregon.
Classic car. How mechanics are transforming these old beauties into energy-efficient roadsters.
Wheels on Wheels people need your help.
Oh my God, people are driving behind that store.
For more information and to donate, scan the QR code on your screen or visit MOWP.org. Wheels on Wheels people, changing lives. Making memories, and you can count on Honda to help you make them. Whether it's in a capable Ridgeline, adventurous CRV, a rugged Passport, or a dynamic car, start making memories of your own with a new Honda during Happy Holidays. Buy online, reserve from select dealers, or visit your local Honda dealer today.
Thank you.